The Boeing KC-46 Pegasus is an American military aerial refueling and strategic military transport aircraft developed by Boeing from its 767 jet airliner. In February 2011, the tanker was selected by the United States Air Force, USAF, as the winner in the KC-X tanker competition to replace older Boeing KC-135 stratotankers. The first aircraft was delivered to the Air Force in January 2019. The Air Force intends to procure 179 Pegasus aircraft by 2027. The KC-46 Pegasus is a variant of the Boeing 767 and is a wide-body, low-wing cantilever monoplane with a conventional empennage featuring a single fin and rudder. It has a retractable tricycle landing gear and a hydraulic flight control system. The Pegasus is powered by two Pratt and Amp Whitney PW 4062 engines, one mounted under each wing. It has been described as combining the 767-200ER's fuselage with the 767-300F's wing, gear, cargo door and floor with the 767-400ER digital flight deck and flaps. The KC-46 uses a similar maneuvering characteristics augmentation system, MCIS, to that implicated in two 737 MAX crashes. In March 2019, the USAF began reviewing KC-46 training due to this feature. Unlike the 737, the KC-46's MCIS takes input from dual redundant angle of attack sensors and disengages with stick input by the pilot. The flight deck has room for a crew of four with a forward crew compartment with seats for 15 crew members, and in the rear fuselage, either palletized passenger seating for 58 or 18 pallets in cargo configuration. The rear compartment can also be used in an aeromedical configuration for 54 patients, 24 on litters. Quick ingress from the ground is available via a ladder that can be pulled down near the front landing gear. The KC-46A can carry 212,299 pounds, 96,297 kilograms, of fuel 10% more than the KC-135 and 65,000 pounds, 29,000 kilograms, of cargo. Survivability is improved with infrared countermeasures and the aircraft has limited electronic warfare capabilities. It uses manual flight controls, allowing unrestricted maneuverability to avoid threats anywhere in the flight envelope. At the rear of the KC-46 is a fly-by-wire refueling boom, supplemented by wing air refueling pods at each wingtip and a centerline drogue system under the rear fuselage so it can handle both types of refueling in one mission. The boom includes a hydraulic relief valve system, similar to those on the KC-10 and KC-767 tankers, to relieve axial pressure in the event of excessive loads building up on the boom. In order to address the stiff boom issue, which keeps a KC-46 from refueling lightweight, thrust-limited receivers like the A-10, Boeing is replacing the current actuator with one using a pressure flow PQ valve in the 2023 timeframe. Rather than using a single boom operator seated or prone at the tail looking out a window, the aerial refueling operator station, AROS, seats two operators at the front of the tanker. AROS includes three main displays for each operator to display images from multiple multi-spectral cameras distributed around the aircraft. The central 2D 3D display provides a rear-facing view for boom refueling operations. Boom operators can execute their mission in total darkness with both aircraft blacked out. The hybrid 2D-3D system requires stereoscopic glasses to be fully effective.